Hi everyone, thanks very much for joining us today. I'm Ian Heffley, one of the admissions counselors for the Africa programs here at SIT Study Abroad. And I'm joined here virtually in Vermont by one of our alumna from the South Africa Multiculturalism and Human Rights Program. Grace, would you like to introduce yourself a little bit?
Sure. Hi, everyone. My name is Grace Gamble. I'm a junior at the College of Worcester, where I'm a sociology major and a French minor. And this past semester, I studied abroad in Cape Town, South Africa, with the Multiculturalism and Human Rights Program through SIT.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much for joining us today, Grace. And let's just jump right into the questions here. There are quite a few options to study abroad in South Africa or direct enroll in Cape Town. So what made you choose SIT's program in Cape Town?
I think that I was drawn to SIT because of the aspect of experiential learning. I really wanted something that would allow me to delve into another culture and to really better understand where I was. And I felt that coursework, of course, is important, but I kind of wanted something that was different from the traditional college experience. So I thought that experiential learning would be a really beneficial component that SIT had to offer. And I was really excited to engage in the independent study project and be able to participate in field research and also experience living with a host family.
Excellent. So I'm going to be a little pedantic here now. And if you had to choose one aspect of the many aspects of the SIT program that you just mentioned as your favorite, what would that be?
That's a good question. I think I would say the host families. I think particularly my program, because we traditionally have four different host families. My experience, we had three. I think it was really beneficial to be able to see different lenses of South African culture through staying with different families. And I think that I did a large amount of my learning in the home, just interacting with the families and understanding their history, where they had come from, sharing in traditions like food and hearing their stories was really fantastic and also allowed me to build really beneficial relationships that I'm still able to maintain today.
A lot of students do mention that the homestay family is their favorite aspect, and I know I'm still in touch with some of the homestay families from my study abroads.
Yeah.
So to change aspects a little bit here, you mentioned the independent study project as well. Have you had an opportunity now that you're back at your home college to continue the studies along the topic or the theme or the location that you studied in Cape Town?
Yeah, actually, my ISP has been really beneficial in my current college career. So I was able to give a presentation about it at a vegan meal that a local church offers monthly. And I also am continuing the same topic in the States for my independent study at Worcester. So I looked at urban agriculture nonprofits and their marketing tactics. So I'm going to do the same thing in the States, looking at Cleveland, Detroit, and Youngstown, whereas in South Africa, I just focused in Cape Town. So it was very beneficial to have get some like background literature and some experience doing that field research. And it was a really good inspiration for my own senior project.
And what better setting to do it in than one of the most beautiful cities on the planet?
Exactly.
So make sure you keep us informed when you go further with your ISP there, because we love hearing about what the alumni do. So now, believe it or not, you attended one of our bigger programs, because I believe there was about 23, 24 students with you that semester.
Yes,
and most of our programs are capped on 25, so we can really give you a close personal experiential learning environment, which is positive for the students are there, but it also means a lot of people don't get to hear about us. So.
Right.
How would you explain SIT to someone who doesn't know who we are?
That's a good question, too. I think that the experiential learning component that I spoke about previously is really what's integral to SIT. Just kind of focusing on a non-traditional college experience that allows you to engage with another culture in a different way. I also think that the independent study project is another central component of SIT. And something that I really experienced was really being forced to question things and to not take what I had learned kind of as the truth in college, and to sort of relook at systems and learn how to kind of like deconstruct things and see the world in a different way. So I think that SAT really challenges people to reconstruct their worldview through this aspect of experiential learning and homestays and independent study.
Excellent. So now I want to ask you a kind of a two-parted question here.
Sure.
If there was one thing that you know now that you wish you knew before you applied for the program, what would that be? And is it something that you don't think you could have learned anywhere else?
I guess I would say I wish I knew just to like savor every moment. You know, I think that sounds really cheesy, but I think when you're abroad, sometimes you can kind of like get distracted and or so comfortable with your experience, particularly for me during ISP, that you kind of forget that you're really having this incredible life-changing experience and you really should savor every single moment of it. So I guess I would say just remember that this is something you're never going to have again in your life. And, you know, if you decide to spend the day being lazy in bed once, like that's fine, but you can do that in the States. And I think that it's more important to go out and do something different because you're never going to have exactly the same experience again.
That is something I told myself all the time during Peace Corps. So now we are coming to the end of our interview today, but I wanted to see if you wanted to reach out to the student who's watching this, who is contemplating studying abroad in general, in Africa, or on the same program, and you wanted to tell them one thing, what would that be?
I would say, you know, let yourself be uncomfortable. I think that's the most important thing about abroad. Don't go into the experience thinking that you're going to be comfortable the entire time, and when you feel uncomfortable, embrace that, and don't let that be something that holds you back from studying abroad, because I think it's a really integral aspect that really allows you to grow and change as a person.
Very, very nice. Well, thank you again for taking some time today. Is there any last words that you want to say? Something you miss from Cape Town?
Something I miss from Cape Town. I guess my favorite part of Cape Town is just the really warm and welcoming culture, and just in general, the people. So that's definitely something that I miss. And I think it's so important for people to engage with different cultures and get to experience that really warm embrace of another group that kind of unites you in a really unique way.
Well, let's see if I can pull up some of my old Zulu or Xhosa with Niyabonga Grace Sala Kwatsi or Sala Gatli. There we go.
Yes.
Okay. Well, thank you. Okay. Thank you very much for taking
thank
some
you.
Time. And make sure you keep in touch with our alumni office, okay?
Yes, definitely. And Kosi.
Have a good day.
You too. Thank you.